Hello and welcome to the Grizzly Cubs Sports Update. The month of April featured a full schedule for all of our spring sports. Carla Gildersleeve has a severe case of senioritis and it's towards the end of the school year, so she decided not to come today. But to start off, the men and women's track and field teams started the month off with a solid double win over Shelbyville. The teams followed up with that performance with another double win over conference rival Martinsville on senior night. At the Johnson County track meet, Lily Lacey was a county champion in the 16 and 3200 meter races. Maggie Ogier finished county champ in the 400, and the boys 4x800 team of Ethan Pfeiffer, Drew Hargis, Will Tucker, and Andrew Bixler finished as champions. The teams ended the month with the Mid-State Conference meet. The men's team finished third, while the women's team finished fourth. The 4x8 team of Ethan Pfeiffer, Wyatt McCullough, Drew Hargis, and Andrew Bixler finished Mid-State Conference champs. Lillian Lacey was a conference champion in the 1600 and 3200 meter races, and Addie Utterback won the pole vault to be crowned conference champ. Congrats to all for a great season so far. Both teams are gearing up for sectional action, which starts in about 2 weeks. It has been a very busy month for baseball. They started off the month with a pair of wins over conference rival Plainfield, then picked up another conference win over Perry Meridian. On April 11th, FCHS dedicated the baseball field and officially named it Mercer Field in honor of the Mercer family and all that they have done for FCHS baseball over the years. The team capped off a special night with a dominating win over the Cardinals of Southport, 11-0. The Grizzly Cubs then faced off conference rival Wyland. The team split a back-to-back with the Cubs winning the second matchup 10-3 behind a complete game from Luke Miles. The Grizzly Cubs also split a two-game series with Mooresville. In the latest conference matchup, the Grizzly Cubs faced off against Martinsville. Luke Torrance had a two-run homer to help the Cubs win 4-1. The softball team is having a heck of a season so far. With a record of 12-3, they are in the hunt for a conference title. The ladies picked up a conference win against Martinsville, defeating the Artesians 5-1. They also had a sweep of Mooresville last week. They host Martinsville tonight and face conference opponents Greenwood and Decatur Central in the coming weeks before starting sectional play, where they will face Wyland. The women's tennis team has been having an excellent season so far and are currently undefeated, and this has made them become 19th in the state. During regular season action, they have had big wins over conference opponents. They are back in action tonight at the conference tournament, going for the title. Good luck, ladies. The men's golf team has been battling some rainouts, but in the matches that they have gotten in, they have been performing very well. They started off their season winning the Brown County invite. Damon Dickey led the way, earning medalist honor. The team followed up that win by earning the top honor against Shelbyville. Quinn Edwards shot a 38 to earn medalist honors. In a three-team match, Franklin edged out conference opponents Mooresville and Wyland to bring home a win. Damon Dickey again earned a medalist honor, shooting a 35. The men's volleyball team has had a great season so far. They are currently ranked 7th and have had some big wins over major opponents. They recently had some exciting 5-set matches against Brownsburg and Cardinal Ritter. The Grizzly Cubs came out victorious in both matches. Both JV and varsity teams also swept the home quad with wins over Carmel, Lafayette Jeff, and Southport. Many of the Grizzly Cubs teams are gearing up for tournament play. Don't forget to follow Franklin Athletics on Twitter to stay up to date on all Franklin athletics. And Carla, hope you enjoyed your day off.